That was mainly me playing around with Gruul in Historic, I think. But it doesn't matter this season because apparently June, July, and August are all going to qualify for the same month. So no need to rank up for July for me. What is this? Timur. Yep, that's a bad matchup. All the untapped lands I could find, so you need to race. Yes, I would say so because before the whole shakeup that happened with what do you call that, Yorion Luka, it was Timur that was keeping Rakdos down. Because if you don't kill them early, then you lose. But then you can't kill them early because you're Rakdos. You're not really super aggro. You're sort of aggro. You have a much slower clock. So that was the problem then. But then when all these Bant decks appeared that pretty much killed reclamation decks, and so that allowed Rakdos to sneak in. And one problem with reclamation deck is you're iffy about the claim the firstborn, which is arguably one of the best cards right now versus Bant. You can get away with putting all four of them in, which shouldn't be the case, right? Because you're an aggro deck versus a mid-range deck. Your claim of the firstborn is like your anti-aggro mirror card. It shouldn't be doing so well versus the mid-range matchup. But it is because of Uro, because of Hydroid Crisis, because of Nissa lands. It's just amazing in that matchup. So here, I think I'll cut maybe two, maybe three. Think he probably has ooze. And so that's the dilemma, right? If he has ooze, why am I cutting? Yeah, I think I cut priest here. Maybe a grasp for the wolf. Yeah, maybe two grasps. Let's stick to one grasp. Maybe I should have two grasps. So the best way to win versus Temur Reclamation has been to turn three Regisaur. I'll keep this. Might get board wiped, so. And it's not like a priest would kill anything on turn 3 anyway. I think I force him to board wipe here. If I force the board wipe, I still get a cauldron familiar out of it, and then 4 additional damage from these guys. But not, that's not really okay. That's a good sign. We can still get that 3 to cast instant. Okay. Okay, I'm actually okay with this. So we don't want to cash in the familiar because he might have that board wipe. Alright, that is okay. So now we do want this. That's okay. Still not there where Uro is concerned. 3 things in the graveyard, 4 things in the graveyard. Still needs 2 more things in the graveyard. Are we dead to that? I don't think we're dead to that yet. Oh, hello. Hello. That's pretty good. Yep. I'm gonna use this cry here now. Does that kill him? Don't think so. Wait, let's do some math. It's going to block the Ghost Rider. I'll get in 1, 2, 3, down to 8. But then he'll get to eat a lot of stuff. So I don't think. Yeah, for every one, he has all the green mana he can want, so no there. Then we want to get the familiar out before the reclamation mana goes up. Right. What does he have? So our only chance here is to steal that ooze, I think. Yeah, our only chance here is to steal that ooze. Come on, eat. No. So you have a counter spell. Either gust. You have either gust. No, either gust. You do, you're looking at my spell. That won't really work the way you think it's going to work. Okay. Sure. hoping you don't have a counter spell. That's fine. Can't kill him yet. And I think we're... Are we dead to another explosion here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 3 excess. 5 if he has another land. Okay. Now that's still very bad. That's still very bad for us. Yeah, I think I'll pack it in. Okay, I think I do get rid of all the priests. I put in one. Claim the firstborn because of the scavenging oozes. I get rid of the call of the death dweller because of the scavenging oozes. I put in noxious grass. Or do I want the soul guide lantern? No, we have claimed the firstborn. So maybe I put in one priest of the forgotten gods. Yeah. Okay. Okay, first. Okay, we have the Regisaur hand, so let's see if this works. Yeah, Temoris is a pretty good counter to Rakdos Sacrifice, I would say. Right. Attack first. Drop the Regisaur. Right. Hopefully this is enough. Swing first because he might have a bounce spell. That works too, I guess. Okay. So that can kill the Regisaur. Oh, cool. Alright, that's lucky. That's lucky. Swing, I think. What was the argument to playing against Rider first? I didn't know what they had. They can bounce the Regisaur with, I don't know, Borrower? Can I steal Giganta here? I can't anymore, right? Sure. I wanted him to make a decision of double blocking the Regisaur to kill it. If okay, so Sublime just. Lime didn't just drew them a card, I guess. Swing first. That's fine. Can't cast Giganta, so we can't take him out. Maybe I was too greedy with the. Maybe I was too greedy with the play with the wolf. I don't want this. So here he can Uro. That stops our Regisaur train. Okay. Still have no choice but to attack here. Have another either gust. Yeah. That's still fine. Let's take. Yeah, if I just killed the wolf there, then he would have still blocked the murderous rider. Is he up for Uro mana yet? I mean, Uro graveyard.
Ah, so many lands. Okay.
Looks like we're dead. Mm-hmm.
Oh gosh, I made the mistake. Eh, I'm.
Because he gets Uro, there's no way I could draw anything that will be able to beat that. Yeah, if I had killed the wolf first before attacking, then he would have probably blocked. He would have still blocked the murderous rider. I wouldn't have gotten a card from it. The murderous rider would have died. Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't think it would have mattered. Village Rites is such a good card in this deck. This Bant or Blue White Control.
Yes, Elspeth conquers death mana, so I didn't want to. Didn't want to cast Mayhem Devil. Drew nothing there. Scry. Another land. Down the bottom you go. Dream Trawler. Game over.
The Dream Trawler here is most likely game over.
That's fine. You're going to bounce the familiar? Probably not.
I've got it. stop that. Now!
I think we're going to run into Elspeth Conquers Death here if we play, cast this. But then if we don't do anything, we'll be behind by a lot. If he does go Elspeth Conquers Death, I think we have to do this. We can steal Midnight Reaper. Swing to Teferi. Okay, not Elspeth Conquers Death. That's good. If he bounces here, then we can kill the Teferi.
Oh, I've done the hero thing before.
Play the land first, and play this. Oh yes, Aelergust, Aelergust. Resolve, take action. Okay.
Don't worry, I got this.
Okay.
Let's make this quick.
Jor-El's going to get another creature out. Oop, why did I throw that? It's going to play land. I guess I want to kill Jor-El here. Do I want that or do I want him to tap Jor-El? Maybe I just kill Teferi. Oh no, he's going to make another 2-2. It'll probably be best to kill this. You can only target your own creatures with the Teferi phase out. So that won't work. out. Swing at this Teferi.
We want to draw that card.
Okay. Want me to phase you out of time?
Witch's Oven would be a fantastic draw here.
Let's try this.
We can go for Uro. We have in our yard nothing. Cautious about. Right, we can deal one damage to. Yeah.
Hey, that was uncalled for.
He's cautious about using Uro. I think I swing to this Teferi. Yep. I can also. Yeah. I'll swing to this Teferi. Can also try to swing here, but what he'll do is he might phase out this creature. That's fine, I think. I'll get to kill two of them, draw a card, get the Mayhem Devil in the yard, which is what I want to do. No, just that one. Because then it will be a good idea for him to phase out Midnight Reaper. There you go. Yeah, before blocking. So that would have been bad. Losing the cat is fine. Okay. Okay.
Here we go.
It's time to go for it. Probably not a good idea to take 5 damage to draw a card, right? So we'll still be drawing cards from here.
This one out.
That's not good.
I'll protect you.
Then he can swing. Okay. Okay.
Should have seen that coming.
Still have nothing here for a call. Can get two creatures, but I think it's better off with this.
Nope, no attacks.
Okay. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Can block. Okay. Safe. Can block with the mayhem. I can block with both. And then draw two cards. But then he'll just get it back, get this one back. I think I block here. Yeah, I think I block here. Might be a blowout. Like, he might have that big counter spell, but then we're dead to that anyway. We can counter this spell if we just block with the Mayhem Devil. How we wanted it to go. He can draw two cards and then we can call the Mayhem Devil. Okay. He already plussed with Teferi, so he can't face something out next turn. Alright, still need to draw Cauldron, the Witch's Oven, would be nice. Okay, need a nice draw. Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect. Okay. I grab Uro. Swing both to Teferi. But I have no way of... Oh, wait. I have no way of sacrificing. Right. Right, no way of sacrificing Uro. Hi Ryan, it's fine. Cool. If you were already in June, you don't need to rank up. I think it's still in this. That did not pan out well. Okay. He will get his Ural back. I think he just cast these two guys. I think I can. Yay! All right. Okay, yeah, good luck. It's a pretty good deck. I mean, yep, no blocks. She will Uro again. A lot of time is being used for this game. So my opponent's at 18 minutes. I am at 19. So still good. Nice. This is good. So what's the sequence here? I think Wolf Strider first, or call first. Call first. Yeah, no, Wolf Strider first. Wolf Strider first. Wolf Strider. Call. Now he needs to minus Woe Strike. He doesn't do that. I guess he can still do that. Right. So I shouldn't do anything yet. Have to wait for him to plus the Teferi. Probably has another board wipe by now. Yep. If I let all these die, then I'm down to.
Respect your elders.
So I'll be down to 2. It's fine. Yeah. Down to 3. Yep, we're dead.
The land fights for us.
No. Okay, so we put in the grasps and just the agonizing remorse. That's it. We cut call and then the scorpions. Oh, and we need the soul guide. Maybe cut all the calls. No, leave one, cut the scorpion. Yep.
You mainly want the artifact? The Soul Guide Lantern versus Elspeth Conquers Death. You want to blank out the third saga.
This is fine. Blood crypt, agonizing remorse. Agonizing remorse. Yeah, it's fairy.
Well, could have gone worse.
Nice. I want to do this first. Board wipe here. No, okay. This now and steal this. So now he has the board wipe. And we'll be drawing a lot of cards. Okay. It's not dead yet. Okay, that went well. Didn't see scavenging moves. I don't think I want to put back any of the calls, but I wouldn't take this out also. So I'll keep this. I can't keep this. Okay, this is fine. Guess I take out call. Turn two priest isn't bad. Especially for versus a deck that occasionally plays two drops. What should I do here? If I agonize in remorse first. No, I think worst case that could happen is Teferi will bounce my priest. I think I'm fine with that. Just so I can get this out already. And so next turn I can agonizing for see if there are board wipes. Okay, that's fine. We have a claim for that. Okay, agonizing remorse first. So we do take out Nissa here. Yes, crashes and shatter. So we take out Nissa.
I must go.
And we play a swamp. Yes. Attack. So now he would probably glass casket our priest, which we will respond. We will let that hit the board. Now we know his hand. We know there's a board wipe. Oh. Oh. Or justice. Should we sweeten the pot with a Cauldron Familiar? Yeah, I'll sweeten the pot with a Cauldron Familiar. Just to entice him to board wipe. And so, also, so in case he doesn't board wipe and plays a Hydra instead, we can get rid of the Hydra. Board wipe. Is this good enough for a board wipe? Okay, okay. Good, good. Oh, perfect. It still has a board wipe though. Right. Guess. Let's play this. Will want to board wipe now. No, so we'll just get this back. Play this tap. See what he does. Not yet Uro time. So we can kill that. Okay. So I kill that. Yes.
After a thousand years, I'm getting the hang of this.
Okay. So we escape the Woe Strider and then claim the Jor-El. So he'll have a choice of whether to make the Woe Strider disappear or make the beast disappear. That's fine. So he wants to make the priest disappear. Okay. I wanna kill the Teferi, so I'll steal this guy. I need to kill the Teferi because he can board wipe anyway. He'll probably lose Jor-El anyway. Probably will block here actually. If he doesn't block, at least I'm sure that Jor-El won't be there next turn, so he'll still board wipe. But then I'll get my priest back after he board wipes. Okay, he's not blocking. Which is strange, because that means he doesn't want to board wipe next turn. We don't have that yet. Right, we want that. We're a bit pressed for time, we're at 7 minutes. Play this first. We want the two. Yep. So we'll have two foods. We still have one food. That's fine. Right. I think he valued that too much. I guess I force him to board wipe finally. Now comes the Uro. Right. Yeah, I think he valued Jor-El there a bit too much. Ooh. He can't top deck board wipe. That's fine. I think we still win if he does. Yep. So this is game. Okay, I think that's all the time I have for today. So yeah, I still think Rakdos Sacrifice is currently the best deck in the meta. Of course, that will change if a lot of people start playing Temur Reclamation again, or if Bant if Bant stops playing two drops, then yeah, Rakdos may take a backseat again. But for as long as your mid-range, your choice mid-range deck is playing a lot of stuff that can be claimed the Firstborn, I think that Rakdos will be a very good choice for tournaments.